Keep on trying. What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the Sports Drive here on the Arena Sports Network and on Blab. Blab, hopefully you got your shenanigans out of the way and we can have a fun show with no interruptions. I am Josh Lopez here on this Thursday, May 19, 2016. This is the post-hump day edition of the Sports Drive. And, hey, there's a national trend going on right now saying National Sending Nude Day. What the blue hell's going on here?
I'll tell you what.
Seriously, man.
Hell.
It is. We got a fun show planned for you guys. As always, if this is your first time tuning in, this is the most non-politically correct sports talk show you'll ever see in your life. You could have fake tough guys say it from New York on Sports World Radio, but we actually bring it to the table here on the Sports Drive every single day. Anyways, this show's live every Mondays, Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays here on Blab. An hour earlier on Fridays for our Potluck Friday episode so we can get to our weekends a little early and have some fun. And we have a good show planned for you today. We'll get to the rundown after the introductions, but public service announcement is always for you oversensitive bitches who can't take a joke whatsoever. As it goes like this, we bust each other's chops, we bust other people's chops. There is some vulgar language in between, especially when we get to Boston sports, because Sean sure loves to say the word bullshit every other chance he gets.
Doggone right I do. Don't mess with Boston sports, the city of champions.
Or the fat whale, known as Pablo Sandoval. That's neither here nor there. Okay.
How about Panda Ghost for Jake Arrieta?
I can't kick him out.
No, that's an example of what the Sports Drive is. Also, don't forget, in the second hour, we'll be joined by our lovely snowman for the Skippy Bayless Bash Hour, the best segment in all of sports. Anyways, lovely. Let's get to the Gene Honda introductions. Yeah.
Who goes first? Hey, glory humps.
This goes first, jackass. You really think Chris Sale's gonna go to the Red Sox? Stop.
Yeah, please. Dude.
What are the Red Sox anyway?
Dude, you know what?
That's a good question, you little twerp. All right, let's go.
Yes, Frank.
Yeah, listen, give Brownie Master the benefit of the doubt. There's no MLB in Kentucky anyway.
Yeah.
All this guy's got cornfields, KFC, and y'all.
They have horses. Hey, wait a minute. They got horses, you gluey hump.
Oh, yeah, and play bluegrass music in the state of Kentucky with Kentucky.
Well, I got three rap bastards who hail from all three blue bumblebee sections of the United States. Let's introduce these rap bastards to you right now. Our first victim hails from Blue Bumblebee, Indiana. He is a Donald Trump lackey. He is the George Michael of the Sports Drive. you can see him at your local fine establishments with a black leather jacket and some shades on his side. He loves Chicago, not only the city, but also the band. Got to make that perfectly clear. He's a Chicago Cubs fan. He is a census fan. And for some reason, he thinks he could be a president and turn everything into extreme environments. He is the big win, Frank Sprinkle.
Hey, I got a question to ask you. What was this about the first reference to George Michael? There were two George Michaels that I knew of. There was a George Michael as in George Michael of Wham and then solo music. And then there was a George Michael sports machine, God rest his soul. So which George Michael is it?
You're the singer.
Why? But why, dude?
I said you look like the singer.
I look like George Michael. Dude.
Yes. Oh, I figured it out. Frank is definitely with that leather jacket, John Travolta from Saturday Night Fever.
Yes.
Oh, staying alive.
Hey, Sean, keep the music to the beat.
Really.
Oh, yeah. Or how about some grease there, Frank? Let's put some grease lightning on. There you go, Josh. Yeah, grease.
That movie sucked. anyways, our next victim hails from Blue Bumblebee, Kentucky. He is the landlord of the KFC Yum Center. He has businesses for KFC in Nashville and also Kentucky. He is a self-proclaimed bowling master. Hey, Goldie Gopher, shut up. We also have a man, for some godforsaken reason, is a LaQueen fan.
What?
He also loves the Philadelphia Eagles. He's unique, that is for sure. He is the Brownie Master, Andrew Browning.
How's it going, you humble?
Hold on, Sean. We're introducing Browning.
Frank, I was saying, he also lives in a state where the Kentucky Derby and the Triple Crown are very popular. Horse races.
Who gives a rat's ass about the Kentucky Derby?
Sean, we already figured that out.
All right, go ahead, Browning.
Yeah, as far as it runs by a Patriots fan over there.
I got a Brady t-shirt on.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, don't be surprised if Browning and Sean go after each other during this show.
Go ahead, Frank. Sorry.
Yeah, well, Sean, you're not going to get Giselle anyway. Giselle's married to the actual Tom Brady.
Sean, I wouldn't even go after Giselle in the first place, so you have nothing to worry about.
But I can always say the only reason why Browning is so good with his bowling is because those bumpers help him out. I actually bowl by the rules. I'm not the one. And I throw gutter balls because it's only an accident that when I throw it. I try to fiddle right there for bowling.
That's what she said.
Whoa!
That's a good one. Introducing last is certainly not least. We got the one of the Oompa Loompas from the Grinch movie.
What?
we got a man who is a Boston Red Sox fanatic lover. He is the Mark David Chapman of Boston sports fans.
Huh?
He is Pablo Sandoval's attorney. He takes it from Applebee's, Outback Steakhouse, Hooters, and every food establishment known to man before he even takes a step on the field. Oh, he can't because he sit on the bench for the rest of the season with a supposed shoulder injury. Okay. Anyways, this young man is, you can also see me at your fine local establishments known as Walmart, because that's the only thing that happens in Blue Bumblebee, Coeur d'Alene, Idaho. And he is another self-proclaimed bowling master. He is, hopefully he doesn't deflate the show like he's doing with deflate footballs. He is the co-host of the Sports Drive, Sean Mann.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome to the Sports Drive on this Thursday, May 19th, 2016, 8:12 a.m. and which West Coast, which is 11:12 a.m. on the East. And yes,
gosh!
What you realize is that it's Throwback Thursday. We got a man up there who's enjoying his blue bumblebee outfits and Frank Sprankle. We got a man over there.
I wear leather jackets, remember?
Oh, yeah. You're the John Travolta. How much grease have you watched there? Oh, come now, Frank. How much grease have you watched?
All right, Robert.
And we got Browning over here who doesn't know how to bowl properly. And now we get to this. Lastly,
you want to go with that?
Sports Drive. We got a man right here who is a diehard White Sox fan. On a bit of a slump right now, but maybe they'll turn around. A big Blackhawks. Oh. They've won 3 cups this decade. He's also a Bulls fan, and they've won 6 championships. And also a Bears fan.
Better that seed than the Patriots. Keep going.
Also, the big.
Keep going.
We also got a man who's a wrestling expert. We also have a man who has to work continuously and write ridiculous Skippy Bayless quotes. Since we have that in the hour.
Yeah.
Hey, now it's Josh Lopez, the host of the Sports Drive.
I am the director of chaos of this function in the junk.
Yeah, you are.
Frank affectionately calls me the gluey hunt, so I'm the glue that keeps this thing together. What's up, Justin, you rat bastard?
Oh, we got Justin in the house. He's the diehard Marlins and Heat and Dolphins fan.
Hey, Justin, were you hanging out with Laramie Tunsil last night with your gas mask? I got to know. Please, by the way, Sean, don't call me a wrestling expert. Yes, I study the business, but I hate people who call themselves expert. They come off really baggery.
How about wrestling opinion. Man? We could do that. We could do wrestling man.
Yes. All right. Although there I should you go. Be called like Walmart. Yes, I was.
And don't forget, this show is brought to you by Walmart. Go to Walmart and always get every Walmart.
Walmart?
It
is. Send us a screen grab of you taking a haircut at Blue Bumblebee Barbershops in Walmart. I have to know this. Please send it at the. We're on Twitter, by the way, at the Sports Underscore Drive. If you want to follow us on Twitter, Walmart Boys at Twitter, Sean Man ASN, Brownie Master at Brownie Master, and the Big Win at Big Win.
Justin,
Frank.
I saw that comment, and I don't like it.
Oh, poor Boobala. Let's get the violins out. Hey, Walmart boy, tell everybody what's going on
right,
on the show
ladies
today.
And gentlemen, here's our show that we got today on this Thursday, the 19th of May, 2016. We got the intro out of the way. Next up is our opening rant. Josh rips a satire site? Oh, it's something I know about. Penguins are up 2-1 against the Tampa Bay Lightning. Jeff Hornacek to the Knicks. On this day in sports history, famous birthdays, Skip Bayless Bashour, and lastly, it is Fact or Fiction. That is our show for today.
Yeah, Fact or Fiction, Smoking Word, all that good shenanigans, and your questions. If you have any questions in the chat room, please, by all means, knock your socks off. We'll try to answer it to the best of our abilities. I'll let Sean doesn't bring his bias Bostonian perspective to everything today. We'll see. We're on the right track so far. So we're getting there. Yes. All right. Who wants to go versus the opening rants? You want to hear my opening rant?
Say, sure, why not? Let's do Josh it. Last. I want to do my opening rant.
Go ahead.
All right,
this is addressed to a man that's not here with us until the next hour. This is addressed to a man who is a diehard football fan. Snowman, messing me about your fake goddamn college football. It's me, for Christ's sake. I don't care about lousy, stinking college football. I don't care about the top 25 schools. I'm like trying to message him. I'm watching the Red Sox-Royals game a few nights ago. Red Sox are losing the game. All of a sudden, I get bombarded with a message from Snowman going, yeah, baby Sean, college football is coming back. We got the top 25 schedule. And I said, great, lovely. I'm intrigued. Hey, Mr. Snowman, you and I will always be buddies, but please, let's not think about football until it gets here around.
Hey, Sean, do me a favor. Please reiterate this when Snowman is actually on camera in the next hour, okay?
It beats college basketball.
But I don't want to think about
college better than college basketball.
Better than college
basketball. College football,
you know what?
Is the best.
One of the things I said to Snowman was this a few days ago. I said on my phone, he gives me this top 25 football schedule, and he's telling me all about how happy he is, and I put Z. I hate college football, except one favorite college football team that I've got, Montana Grizzlies, because I always went to Montana Grizzly football games since I live 3 hours away from the school.
Yeah, their uniforms are brought to you by Walmart. All right, Walmart boy, your rant is over. Browning, you have anything you'd like to say?
Just slap in the face.
No, I got anything, so you can go ahead with yours, Josh, if you want to.
Oh, by the way, LOL, AJ Styles will lose because this is World Wrestling Entertainment, not Bingo Hall Entertainment.
I hate to say it, LeShit sucks, and he's the most overrated basketball player in the history of the NBA. Bastard.
Mr. Sprinkle, any rants for you, my friend?
Yeah, you guys are completely nuts. That's my opening rant.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
That's my opening rant,
Frank. I didn't know you were nuts.
I am nuts. I'll admit it.
Okay.
I am
the guys. Well.
It's kind of crazy. Everybody here is older than I am. Browning, Sean, and Frank.
Oh, Justin!
Burn.
All right. You guys ready?
Yeah.
Yep. I previewed this in the conference call today. Uh-oh. So there's an article from The Score.
Yeah.
It's a local station here in Chicago. They were talking about Alshon Jeffrey having issues and not appearing at OTAs for the Bears. Look, I there was a time where I was a big Alshon Jeffrey fan, but over the last 2 years, he's become more of a diva and a cancer to this team than Brandon Marshall. Not only does he drop the balls, he doesn't put as much effort in any other wide receiver that's out there. And secondly, this guy, if you poked him, he got injured last year. This dude was in and out of games of every single Bears game this past season, and it pissed me off. Dude, there's players back in the day, 50 years ago, oh, they got a bruised hamstring. They play the damn game. This is Chicago. Have some balls.
I got a
don't give me the excuse of, oh, it's a cold weather city. I don't want to be here because Brandon Marshall's not be here. If you don't want to be here, don't be here. It's that simple. I'd rather have guys bust their ass. They may not be the most talented people in the world, but hell, they actually play for a team that's built on working class and kicking people's ass.
Not being
a bunch of pussies.
What's turf though?
Like Alshon Jeffrey. Oh, my wrist is hurting. I'm gonna take the week off. Oh my, my abdominal is not working this week. I'm so sick of that freaking schmuck. I'm gonna put half effort, and then when it's time for me to step up as a leader on the team, no, I gotta sit out every other game because I'm a freaking pussy. This is the Chicago Bears. This is not the Detroit Lions. This is not the Jacksonville Jaguars. And secondly, enough already with the shootings here.
Oh, yes.
Enough.
That's more important. I'll say
200.
God, it's tragic. It's tragic.
And 53 deaths in 139 days. Of the year so far.
I got a question to ask, though. Why does this continue in Chicago? Is it gang members, or is it just people that don't have work or something? I mean, I've never really figured out why this continues.
I'll let Frank answer that in a little bit, but I want to say this. Look, we can keep pointing at that it's the south side of Chicago. That's bullshit. Yeah. Where I live, there's as much deaths over here as is on the south side. The news only touches on the south side. And you know what, Sean? It sucks. I say this every time around the show. I had to fear for my own life, and I want to do something positive in my life. And I feel that so many people are taken away from this world too early because nobody has the balls to actually have a fist fight. Hey, if you have an issue, hand it out with your fist. If you're going to be a fucking coward with no balls, oh, let me grab a gun from Indiana because, oh, I'm not going to get in trouble with that, and I'm going to take somebody's life away from it. It's bullshit.
Let me ask you this, Glory Hump. Are you in fear?
Yeah, I am in fear.
All right.
Would I wish I like to go out more and go to all these different places, blah, 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 blah? Yeah, absolutely. But for what? I'm walking home after I'm, doing a gig. Oh, I'm coming home after hanging out with a couple of friends, and I get shot on my way home walking up the freaking stairs because, oh, what? A friend of mine is related to some gang member that I have nothing to do with or know about? Like, seriously.
Right.
It's bullshit.
It's okay, listen. It's okay to be careful.
If people just go off of the freaking, oh, it's only African-Americans that are shooting people, that's bullshit, too, because there's a lot of Latinos that do the same shit there, too, and Ukrainians and other people. I'm so sick of the freaking media here in Chicago only pointing at the south side. There's people dying two blocks away from where I'm talking to you right now.
Frank, why is this happening with all the shootings? I asked Josh.
Why? I'll tell you why. Oh, I'll tell you why. It's because of the mindset of people. Don't give me any of this bull, you know what, that it's guns. Okay, maybe the guns do trigger. Maybe the guns are the weapon. But let's understand this. People kill, not the guns. People have the mindset to kill. I don't care if it's game baners or not. I don't care if it's game baners on the south side or game baners by where the Gluey Hump lives or some other nutty individual. It's people, Sean. Understand that. I don't get, listen, here's what bothers me. a few years ago, there was a protest by a gun shop in Dalton, which for nobody that is familiar with the Chicagoland area, Dalton borders Chicago on the to the south. It's a south suburb just adjacent to Chicago. There were people actually boycotting the gun store. Wait. There's an issue here. That owner has a constitutional right to sell his products. So if you don't like it, go to Washington, go to Capitol Hill. That's where the Constitution is. So to answer your question, Sean, why does it happen? It's because people have the mindset to kill. It's not the guns. It's the people. There.
You know what? And Frank, you made a good point about this, too. It's been really, really sad. I remember it's horrible. Like I said in the chat room, it breaks my heart all the time when the news has to interrupt. And I have to see all these shootings that have happened. I remember Jonesboro, Arkansas, the shooting there. I remember Columbine. I remember Virginia Tech. I was bad. I just broke my heart with schools. The worst one for me, though, like I've always said, that really broke my heart, and I'm really worried about this all the time, is when children get shot and killed. We all know what happened with Newtown, Connecticut, and when Newtown happened, that was crushing. That broke my heart.
About 30% of the deaths so far this year have involved kids that are under the age of 10. 30% of the people that's died so far this year in Chicago have been under the age of 10.
And I, you know what, I'll remember it like yesterday. Crossfire. Oh, I'm sorry, Frank, I don't want to interrupt. The thing that really, really broke
you're
my heart.
You're saying it's been part of Crossfire.
Well, the thing that really broke my heart. That's all right. The thing that broke my heart the most with Newtown is when we all woke up that Friday morning and we saw the report about the shooting and we saw that 20 innocent children were shot. And I mean, it broke his heart. Yes. You know, I'll never forget when President Obama came out and he spoke to the country and he broke down. I mean, anybody would, because, you know, children, if you have a child, if you have a son or a daughter, your job as a parent is to protect that child. And I know that I can tell you when Columbine happened, I got a bit scared too, wondering and thinking, hopefully it doesn't happen to me. I kept thinking about it because it was really, really sad with it. I mean, wherever shootings are, it's like, and I remember saying this too, when Newtown, Connecticut happened, and that was, we have to protect ourselves wherever we go. Everybody does. Yes. Because nothing is safe. I mean, nothing is safe. And we've seen a lot of bad shootings after 9/11. We've been very close to being attacked before, but I don't know why people do it. If people are crazy and nuts and thinking about wanting to kill innocent life, seriously, get some help. I mean, it's not right of you just to say, I'm going to go on a killing spree and go to a school and open fire there. I'm going to go to a store and open fire there. I'm going to
fight. People, though, Sean, it's people, not guns. It ain't guns. It's people.
Who gives people the right to dictate how long somebody is supposed to live?
And
who gives that right?
And there's complete anger a lot with the American public about with the NRA. Like I told you about what happened when the week after.
I hate that. I hate that. Hey, those people bother me.
Yeah, December 21st, 2014.
Leave the NRA alone.
Yeah, it was a week after. I'm sorry, Frank. It was a week after the Newtown shooting. And I'll never forget, two people came in there. A lady was shouting, saying, "You're killing our children. You need to do something." And another man yelled and said, "This is bullshit. You're not doing a good job of protecting our children. Do something."
The NRA condemns that. The NRA condemns any violence. The NRA is not a violent organization. They just believe in the right to bear arms. They don't believe in the right to kill, to commit mass murder or even one murder. The NRA condemns those acts.
I mean, we got enough problems with this, and we got problems with the world. I mentioned this in the conference call, everybody, about how scary threats are right now. I mean, another thing to get out for an opening rant, I just have to mention this too, is
we better
start being careful with a lot of the other issues with other countries who are really threats to us. North Korea is scary, Russia is scary, and China is becoming apparently a really dangerous threat to the United States. So I tell you, ever since 9/11, everything has really gone. It's almost as if things have just gone downhill and we have never been safe. That's the way I look at it. A lot of people believe, with it being 15 years, we are not safe.
I like Chinese food, though. China's a threat. They got good food, though.
I, I Before we go into the comedy stuff and bring some levity to the situation, I want to read a quote that I read to Sean and Frank in the conference call, and maybe get you guys in thought, and maybe get you guys in a better perspective. And there's a couple of stuff I wrote on Facebook last night. Maybe you'll agree, maybe you're not. But I like the fact that in these opening rants, yeah, we may rant on stuff that we don't like, but at the same time, we get you guys thinking about things that should matter. Don't worry about Donald Trump or how many on and off relationships Selena Gomez has or who's fucking who, who's cheating on who. Like that stuff doesn't mean anything. Your life can be taken away and you're worrying about what boyfriend Selena Gomez has. I mean, there's more stuff to worry about. Anyways, here's a couple of quotes I wrote. One of them has to do with relationships, and another one is just overall trust issues as well. This first one, I spoke personally because this is something I've been dealing with. Personally, a lot of people judge me about being shy and not outgoing or whatever. I said, please forgive me if I don't talk much at times. It's loud enough in my head. Basically, I have enough thoughts in my head that I don't have to express it out all the time. And then the second one, it goes like this. I am a good enough person to forgive you, but not stupid enough to trust you again. Never regret your past. The only thing you should regret is the time you wasted with the wrong people. Every time you get I was addressing women in this scene. Ladies, every time you get on your soapbox about there's no good guys around, oh my God, where's the good guys around? I'm so sick and tired of being cheated, blah, 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 blah. Remember, you put what you wanted in the friend zone.
Yes, you did.
As I look back in situations I was in, I realized every time that I thought I was being rejected from something good, I was actually being redirected to something better. Not everything that meets the eye is ideal. You never know who will be your partner or whatever. But anyways, find your levity, look within yourself, and not only in relationships, have the in life in general, have the courage to make your own fucking decisions. Stop thinking about things that fit a certain criteria so you can impress your friends. There's things that may not be ideal at first, but the ideal things more times do not end up being things you waste the most time on. For example, there may be things that you like to do, that you feel that you're that good at it, but you end up, I could say, oh, I want to be an astronaut, and then, 5 years later, I'm ended up being a broadcaster. You know what I mean? there's other things. Not everything at first is the ideal thing.
Yeah, but I'm not pitching in the major leagues right now like I thought it was.
But you know what? Yeah. I also have to say, as I'm talking with Justin in the chat room and stuff, despite everything that's going on, at least we realize we'd like to bring the joy and the spark to people because of everything that's going on in the world. I mean, you have to have laughter. We have to realize with everything that's going on, it's in God's hands. You know, I mean, that's the way I look at it. I mean, God is one that hopefully will make sure nothing bad happens to any of us. Amen.
Yep. Hey, speaking of laughter, Sean, please bring up the article you were telling me about last night.
Let's get to this story that I heard this story, and I sent Browning this story too, and Snowman, and then Josh told me, and I was like, what? I said, this is a farce? Get ready for this. This is about Tony Romo of the Dallas Cowboys.
Oh, geez.
Uh-huh. Oh, another thing I want to say too, thoughts and prayers about the plane crash that happened this morning from Paris to Cairo.
What? There's a plane crash? Hold on. Sir. Yeah. This is the first time I'm hearing about it.
Yes, I want to also say I offer my thoughts and prayers to the families. One of my sister, Susanna, just said, prayers for the passengers, crew, family, and friends of Flight 804 out of Paris bound for Cairo. Terrorist activity strongly suspected. So,
wow, it's the first time I'm hearing about it.
Yeah, it was on CNN. It was on this morning. So I want to just send my thoughts. We all send our thoughts and prayers to the families after a really sad time that we're living in this country. Anyway, we got to get on to.
Let's get to something lighter.
First off, I'm going to send this, put this in the chat room. Get ready for this one. Here you go, Frank. Take a look. A report. Tony Romo arrested in North Carolina for using men's bathroom.
That doesn't look like an actual mugshot. All right, dude. I want you to explain the story. Explain it.
All right. There has been heated controversy over the recent legislation implemented by the leaders of the state of North Carolina. The state made headlines. created a relative uproar after maintaining its stance on the LGBT community, essentially vetoing a bill that would protect those who are gay, bisexual, and transgender from discrimination. Tony Romo, apparently, Thursday afternoon at approximately 4:57 p.m. Eastern time, North Carolina police detained a man later to be identified as Dallas Cowboys quarterback Tony Romo for using the men's restroom at Charlotte Douglas International Airport.
That is messed up right there.
Josh, you have something to say about this, right?
When you have the address or website called dailysnark.com, just realize you're being worked, bro. This is not true. Tony Romo is not arrested. Dude, there's a gazillion fake-ass wrestling websites that these nimrodic wrestling fans believe every goddamn thing that's reported on that website. Does Uprox ring a bell?
Yeah, we've seen a mugshot, an actual mugshot. That's actually public record.
Tony Romo was not arrested.
That is public record.
It's public record, but it's not an actual story.
I know, that's my point. Okay, if indeed Tony Romo was arrested...
Do some real journalism! Hey,
right, listen, if Tony Romo was indeed arrested, don't you think we would have seen an actual mugshot?
Okay, Justin, I don't care about the Ravens proposal. We'll get to that in another time, but... Like, dude, do your fucking research and get the freaking shit right. Don't come up with some bullshit soliloquy about, oh, I want to see how people react to Tony Romo get arrested article. That's what these nimrods do. Brownie, how many times have you gone to a wrestling website and you know it's completely another bullshit?
Yeah, I'm like, come on, seriously. It's fake.
And there's wrestling fans out there that buy every single article that's reported on the dirt sheets. Every single one. I'm fortunate enough to be in the position where I'm doing play-by-play articles and I don't have to report bullshit. What you see in my articles is the truth because that's basically what happened on the show. So, I mean, come on, man. As a guy who's in part of the media actually has pride in what they do, have the balls to do your shit right, man. Come on.
That's right, indeed. And I just do your research and stuff, too. And I thought it was true, so I was like, I'm going to send it to Josh.
You thought it was true? Oh, my goodness.
I thought it was, so I sent it to Josh yesterday.
Josh, Sean, we're going to give you a hard time now for this. Sean, you're going to be given a hard time now for this.
We're going to boot him anyway to give me a hard time. Police say that...
Go ahead, Sean.
No, that's all right. Police say they received a complaint from numerous bystanders and patrons inside the bathroom complaining of a person who didn't belong there. When asked how they recognized that the man who they received complaints about may have been a woman, they pointed toward the Cowboys apparel Romo was wearing at the time. Quote, it was a dead giveaway, said Officer Mike Rossman.
Oh, the writing is giving this away too, man. This is satire website. Daily Snark, go screw yourself.
Yeah, who's going to believe that? Yeah, I can't believe Sean actually took the bait.
Yeah, really?
You took the bait on the
Snark. Yeah, Sean, that's on you, buddy. You're the one that took the bait.
Justin! Oh, no! All right, everybody's socking it to me. He socked it to me. Yep.
He took the
Hey, you love your Walmart haircuts, but you wear hats all the time.
That's for tradition for me to go in there. That's for
pride. Yeah, that's tradition, but you got to mop all the time. Keep your hat off for one show.
What do you mean? I'm wearing a new hat. That's my John F. Kennedy hat, since Kennedy is my idol. Yes.
He took the Snark right in the Patriots.
John F. Kennedy had his flaws too, but we don't need to
keep it.
I love how everybody talks about Bill Clinton being a cheater as president.
I've heard stories about JFK.
Yeah, exactly.
Does Marilyn Monroe ring a bell?
I am.
Right, you know what? I can't do this, but I'm probably going to get booted anyway, but get out of here. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not going to boot him.
No, it's booting you. Actually, we can't boot anybody out. Remember that.
I can't do that. Heck with that.
Yeah.
But he is my idol. Be careful what you say about him.
Give me a second. I'm going to find a video for you guys.
A video?
One second.
It's addressed towards me.
No, it's not addressed to you, buddy. Don't worry about it.
Shut up, Browning. Shut your mouth. Go eat your Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Not even lunchtime in here, so be quiet.
Yeah, or start focusing on getting your tickets for the Triple Crown.
Horse. Oh, there you go.
Hey, horse races.
Hey, does Mimi Beardsley ring a bell?
Oh yeah, everyone was a kid. Intern. Hold on, before Monica, there was Mimi Beardsley. She was an intern, wasn't she?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm going to play a song for you, actually, on video.
Okay, all right. So, yeah, I want to see. I think I want to see this. Sean may want to avert his eyes.
Oh.
Okay.
Uh-oh. Avert his eyes. Thanks a lot.
Give me one second.
Uh-oh. Yeah, I sent Frank the article about what happened. Really, that's sad.
Yeah, I know.
I don't believe it. I can't start.
That. Oh, here we go.
Mimi Beardsley.
Oh, yes.
That was in my fucking head.
Mimi Beardsley.
Oh, Mimi Beardsley.
Why have we been on the air an hour and a half without hearing that fucking song?
Eat my ass.
Oh, Mimi Beardsley. Yeah.
That's BS. Oh my gosh.
You know, that can brainwash another human being.
Man.
Is that it? Are we done with this video?
What? You want me to shut it off?
Yeah, I would like you to shut it off. Exactly. Wait, that was you?
That was not
me. Come back in here.
That was not me. That was Josh that put that on there.
Whoa, man. It's 20 seconds left.
Hey, Sean, let me ask you this. Hey, Sean, let me ask you this. Hold on. Let me ask Sean this. Since you're a Kennedy family historian, especially since JFK is your idol, is there anybody that you would like to disclose that JFK had an affair with that we don't know? Come on. You can spill the beans. You can spill the beans here.
Maybe, maybe Judith Campbell, maybe.
Man, did he have an affair with some mob wife?
Yes, but I think we'll leave it out of there because the media didn't take it seriously. With Bill Clinton, they did because of what happened with Monica Lewinsky, and that's why.
Because the media is stupid. That's why the media is stupid today, unlike the 1960s.
Doesn't matter.
Hey, you want to see a rant on the Jets?
Shut up, Justin.
Here we go.
Oh, okay.
Give me a second.
You're talking about Bill Clinton, Justin. Okay, at least it's not directed toward my hero. I'll let you know about that.
I'm trying to figure out who my hero is. I don't think
I have a lot of heroes. Oh, thanks. Yeah, Justin, I do too. He's my idol. I've got all kinds of books and films on him. I've been to the library. I've been to a lot of Kennedy stuff. Oh, yeah.
Oh, dear Lord.
Hold on. Time out. He told me to go to 150. Yeah.
me ask you guys this question. Oh, we're still going on.
It's still going on.
Sorry.
That's all right.
Yes. Woody Johnson.
All right, I've seen enough. Right,
let me ask you guys this question. Think about this: the New York Jet fan base has got to be one of the most frustrated fan bases in the NFL. I mean, think about this. Well, you've got the New York. Hold on, but you've got Big Brother, the New York Giants, having won all those Super Bowls over the last couple decades. You have the New England Patriots, and Sean, you know better than anybody what they've been able to accomplish. If I'm a New York Jets fan, I have got to be one of the most utterly frustrated fans in the NFL today. Maybe more than the Oakland Raiders or the Jacksonville Jaguars.
I don't know. You cut the video off. You missed the best part. It was coming right up.
I didn't cut it off. Oh, I'm so, well.
I put
anyway,
it back on.
It wasn't me to cut it off.
Oh, for crying out loud. We got to hurt. We got other stuff we got to get to. But, the Jets, you know, we talked about this before we went on the air, too, about the Jets and their quarterback problems. All right, let's go to 5 minutes, and let's see what Josh is getting at here for the best part. Okay, all right, hold on. I know, I see it.
They're bad.
You know, it's amazing as we talk about the Jets. You know, I know we didn't add this to the show, but before we went on the air today, I was talking with Josh and Frank Browning and Justin and everybody about the New York Jets and their quarterback problems. That's another big thing to them. They have been through so many quarterbacks throughout their history. Joe Namath was their answer because Joe Namath was the guy that had a very good throwing arm. He was very good. He won the Super Bowl for the Jets. But look how you evaluate where this Jet team is. They have been a team that has been rebuilding and rebuilding and rebuilding. And think about it. They have been to some AFC Championship games. They went to the 1982 AFC Championship game. They lost to the Miami Dolphins 14-0.
They are a 7-9 football team at best with Geno.
Hey, Sean, I just realized something. You said they're rebuilding. They've been rebuilding since 1969.
Hey, look what Mike said in the video in that Bills game. Sammy Watkins had 3 catches for 157 yards. And then he said it takes a Jets player 3 years to get that many yards.
And you look at the Jets, too, that they were talking about the decades, you know, about how the Jets, you know, Joe Namath turned him around when he was there from 1965 to 1976. We got to make this quick because we got other stuff to get to. If you go to the 1980s, the Jets had the New York Sack Exchange with Mark Gastineau. They made it to the playoffs a couple of times in 85 and 86 and 1991.
Good teams, all make good teams in that time.
Yeah, the Jets had some very good teams in the decade of the 80s. They had a chance to really maybe have a chance to maybe win Super Bowls in the 80s, and they were close. They had chances. That didn't happen. Mm-hmm. You go to the 90s, you know, they had the laughingstock years when they had Bruce Coslett was there. The worst coach they had was Richie Kotite, who was Jets coach. And that was a bad Jet team in 96.
His last name gives away that.
Yeah, but Sean, you're talking here pre-Bill Parcells.
Bill Parcells, in my opinion.
He turned that team around.
Yes, Frank. Bill Parcells was what turned the New York Jets around in the late 90s.
Yes, he did.
But ever since then, it's like when you've gotten to the 2000s when Bill Parcells left, they had Al Groh, Herman Edwards came in, Eric Mangini. Rex Ryan was kind of like the best thing since Bill Parcells because he could bring motivation. But they've always become sometimes what fans would call the same old Jets. The same old Jets that just always feel like they're going to contend every year and be there, but then they just go down and down and down. Yeah. And Frank brings an interesting point that the Patriots have sticked it in their face four times. The Giants have been the one that has delivered big death blow to Jet fans.
Yes.
But of course, the Jets finally beat the Giants last year, ending a like four-game losing streak or a five-game losing streak to the Giants.
Their whole really? Organization is filled with a bunch of jabronis. Period.
Yeah,
I don't know. No, I disagree. I disagree.
John, is it jabroni?
I disagree. I disagree. The Jets fans are blue collar. These are the guys that live in Queens.
Hey, Frank, Bill Emery is more competent than John Iskey, and he got fired.
Well, Phil Emery made some pretty bad decisions.
Oh, how about bad decisions? Who the hell signs Geno Smith as their franchise quarterback? Or Mark
He's
Sanchez?
He's an interception machine. But yeah, Mark Sanchez, though, you got to give him some props. He took the Jets to back-to-back AFC championship games, although they lost him. But I have to tell you this, too. Is Todd Bowles – I'm already saying it right now on May 19th. Is Todd Bowles on the hot seat?
No.
Maybe next year. Maybe next year if they don't make the playoffs.
Okay. Too early.
Breaking news. I'm actually reiterating the news just to put in the chat room. Because there's a couple of wrestling fans in this room right now. Hey, Justin, is this the real deal that John Cena is hosting the SP?
Oh my God. Why?
John Cena's, wait, what? John Cena's hosting the SP?
Yes, John Cena is, Frank, hosting the SPs in July. Look at Browning Connection.
That is major breaking news.
You know what? I got to say this. I like John Cena in the movies he was just in. Trainwreck was awesome. Sisters he was on with Tina Fey and Amy Fuller was really funny. He's really good. I wasn't always crazy about his wrestling skills or whatever, but I have a lot of respect for John Cena. I'm not a big fan of his. I'm not a big hater of his either, but I respect John Cena. Good for him.
Yeah,
And to answer your question, Justin, yes, I do think WWE is getting more popular nowadays, no matter what Vince Russo's out-of-touch ass has to say.
Vince Russo ruined Nitro, I'll tell you that.
Justin says, I'm a fan of Cena. I think he'll do great at the ESPYs. I can't stand Russo. And welcome, SWT. Thanks for coming in, bud.
Thank you.
How did they determine – I got a question. How did they determine John Cena would host the ESPYs? How was that?
WWE has a relationship with ESPN, so –
Well, let me ask you this, Louie Hump. Let me ask you this. They do have relations. Is it possible that at some point we'll see some WWE actual in-ring programming on ESPN? I'm not talking about the big shows. Maybe a small smaller show, like a one-hour Jack show. Do you think we'll see it maybe on ESPN?
Well, maybe they could have NXT on ESPN 2, something like that.
Yeah, I'm not saying ESPN, ESPN 2, one of those channels.
Are any of you shocked that Cena is actually hosting the ESPYs in July this year?
Yeah.
I want to go off on the Justin's point about Russo. I used to be a big fan of his, and I'm actually like Vince as a person. I think he has his funny moments, but the constant cheap shots. He says 1 minute, okay, bro, I'm not trying to be that guy that be bitter about wrestling, and then he'll spend the entire podcast just ripping today's product. Yesterday on his show called Raw Attitude Era Now and Then, where he compares the Attitude Era Raw to this past week's show, he says, oh, I'm not going to spend any time talking about last night's show because he thought it was the worst thing he's seen of all time, right? And then every time he talks about the matches from the Attitude Era, he brings us something that happened the other night on Raw.
Vince Russo was one of the writers from Vince Russo, Glory Hump, you know, was one of the writers from the Attitude
Era.
Yes,
I do know that, and I interviewed.
He did a great job. He did a great job.
He did an okay job.
I thought he did a better than okay job.
Oh, Frank, trust me, I'm watching a lot of these old Attitude Eras back. It's not as great as you think it is. I'm sorry.
Oh, I thought it was. Oh, it was.
Josh and Frank and Browning, even though Josh, Josh, you're the host of the show and stuff, and we got other stuff to get to.
Let's go on to
Your thoughts very quickly. The Pittsburgh Penguins lead the Tampa Bay Lightning 2-1, and I have something to say about this. Six more wins. Somebody out there in the big state of Ohio is going to be smiling, and we know exactly who it is. It's going to be Wes. I'm going to see Wes just plastering my wall. How about those Penguins, Sean? Stanley Cup champions be like, oh,
Viagra on a pole match, Justin. How about that? The great writing in the late 90s. Yeah. Give me a break, bro.
I have to ask you guys a quick question, though. Your thoughts about the Penguins, though, Frank, if they do win the Cup this year, are you surprised that they'll do it? Think about it. They just beat the Capitals in six games.
I'll tell you what, before the playoffs would be, because you know what? They're playing the Tampa Bay Lightning, and this is a team that, of course, lost to the Blackhawks last year in the finals. But you saw Shea. I think the series is going seven. Who wins? It's hard for me to determine, but I'll say this. I think the series is going seven.
You can't forget the impact Phil Kessel has had on this team. From coming from Toronto, this guy is good. I actually think Pittsburgh has a good chance of winning this series, to be honest with you. Tampa Bay, yes, they've had their moments where they get on a hot streak and you think they're going to be back to where they were last year, but I like Pittsburgh in this one, guys. I really do.
Well, look what I said in the chat room. Justin, I disagree with you. I'm more in favor of seeing a Penguins-Sharks Stanley Cup final next month. Yeah.
I'm looking forward to just being the Stanley Cup.
Really quick before we go to on this day, because we have to go to the bash hour soon.
Sean,
upload the bashing some, por favor.
Por favor.
Your thoughts?
I'm sure Snowman will be here too. Yeah. Sorry.
What's por favor?
Please. Quick thoughts on Jeff Hornacek becoming the head coach of the New York Knicks.
You know what? As I sit here and shake my head about it, I don't like it one bit. Because what can Jeff Hornacek bring to the Knicks? Can he know the triangle offense that Phil Jackson did so well with the Bulls and the Lakers? Highly unlikely. Phil Jackson is looking for a coach, gentlemen, that can run that triangle offense and make the Knicks competitive. But look, the Knicks are a disaster. I've been hearing things about what should they do with Carmelo Anthony. Should Carmelo Anthony be there as a Knick? Josh, Frank, and Browning, or should he be moved? Should he be traded? Should he go to another team? That's a big question. I think Carmelo is the big distraction now instead of Hornacek.
Carmelo should have went to the Bulls when he had the opportunity.
Hey, you know what? Let me ask you guys this. If Phil Jackson is that desperate to run the triangle offense, then you know what he should do? He should assume the head coaching position.
I knew that was coming, Frank.
Because if he is – because here's the thing. Jeff Hornacek, do you get the sense that we heard about Frank Vogel? I'm trying to think. Who are the other candidates outside of Frank Vogel? I think David Platt was a possible candidate. Mm-hmm. Okay, we kept on hearing about these candidates, but don't you get the sense that with this being a shock, that maybe the Knicks had Jeff Hornacek saw all along in their equation that
Jeff
they
Van
had these names? They had these names as decoys. These were decoys for us.
Josh, I disagree with you about that idea about having Jeff Van Gundy.
He's the last coach that brought them to the NBA Finals.
I agree with that, but Jeff Van Gundy, in my view, is enjoying being in the broadcast booth with Mike Breen and with Mark Jackson.
I think he's tired of coaching.
Van Gundy did a great job. I will admit, he saved the Knicks. And, you know, everybody didn't know what to expect out of the Knicks when Pat Riley left. And remember, that was a death blow to Knicks fans when Pat Riley left the Knicks. I'll never forget that. And, Frank, you remember it as well as I do. Remember how fierce and how intense that Knicks Heat rivalry was and how both teams just hated each other?
Oh, there used to be
breaking news. Snowman's here.
Browning, thank you for joining us, bud. Okay, thank you for the
time. This here.
Yeah, see, come on in. Just sit in the chat room and listen to an annoying.
Yeah, we're about to bash Skip. We got to bash Skip.
Yeah, we got to let Sean express his rant towards the snowman.
Oh God!
Oh, this is gonna be funny. Man. But I want to ask though, two gentlemen, about the Knicks. Though, what else do they need? I think they've got so many holes they need to fill. I mean, what else do they need to be competitive in the Eastern Conference?
A great supporting cast around Carmelo Anthony.
Yeah, not Jose Calderon and everybody else.
Yeah, this team is one of the worst supporting casts in the NBA.
Because I can remember, like, yesterday how big the New York Knicks were the Knicks were so big. If
LaQueen went to freaking New York, man. Oh, God.
Ain't going to happen. That ain't going to happen.
I hope not. Snowman, what's up, buddy?
You know what? If LeBron James does go to the New York Knicks, good luck. They're still going to be bad. The Knicks have so many holes they have to fill, and I don't think Jeff Hornacek is going to be the solution. Snowman, your thoughts about Jeff Hornacek becoming the new head coach of the New York Knicks?
Before we go any further, I want to test something. I changed the setting on my
You did,
and I want to be sure y'all can hear something. I'm going to play it at a low level, but I want to be sure. Josh, you're looking good there, buddy. Clean shaven and everything. Wait a minute, are you trying to go back to Bar Louie and impress some folks? I mean, dude, y'all see this guy?
We could go back to Bar Louie another time.
Okay. Let me test something here. Can y'all hear this? Wait a minute. Tell me that this thing is going to start acting stupid. I made an adjustment here, and I know I got to play something. I'm going to try again.
Yeah, hurry up. We got a bad skip.
I know that.
Hey, let's go to Odyssey real quick while Snowman gets.
I'm looking forward to bashing Skip.
Okay, on this day in sports history. Go ahead there, Josh.
On this day in 1910, Cy Young got his 500th win. On this day in 1912, American League President Ben Johnson told the Detroit Tigers that if my mother had balls, she'd be my father. Oh. They continued to protest side cost suspension, they would be banned from baseball. On this day in 1918, the Washington Senators played their first Sunday game. They beat the Indians in 18 innings, 1-0. On this day in 1935, the NFL adopted an annual college draft to begin in 1936. On this day in 1942, Paul Warner of the Boston Braves became the third National League player to hit 3,000 hits. So the Boston teams weren't always in the American League. Day in 1962, Stan Musial set the National League hit record when he got his 3,431st hit. That's a lot. Day in 1974, the Philadelphia Flyers became the first post-67 expansion team to win the Stanley Cup Finals. On this day in 1984, the Edmonton Oilers won their first Stanley Cup Final. On this day in 1988, the Boston Red Sox retired Bobby Dorr.
Yeah,
number one.
He did.
Retired number one jersey.
I see this is not going to work because I'm starting to lag back here. So,
What were we going to play? I was actually looking forward to it.
I'm still trying to play it, and it just will not play for some reason.
You'll get it,
too. Sean, you may have to queue up the theme, and we may have to go soundless here. But
it's ready. Okay. Don't worry, we got it all set. Proceed, Josh. Yeah, go ahead.
I'll only add one more. 1991, Willie T. Robinson was the first African American to drive the Indianapolis 500.
Nice.
Any birthday shout outs today, Josh?
Let me get that really quick for you, rap bastard. Okay. Happy birthday to Chicago product, Kevin Garnett. He turned 40 today. Happy birthday to Malcolm X. Happy birthday to Andre the Giant for you wrestling fans out there. Oh, by the way, Snowman, John Cena's hosting the ESPY Awards.
Yeah, did you hear about that?
Yeah,
did you hear about John Cena? Cena's actually hosting. I cannot believe it.
There's a lot of sports movies, sports birthdays today. Mario Chalmers, he turned 30 today. Archie Manning, he turned 67. Who else? George St. Pierre, a USC fighter, he turned 35. That's pretty much it for today, Sean. Oh, also Nicole Brown Simpson, her birthday would have been today, but we don't need to get to the People versus OJ right now. Hey,
you were three deceased people in that. I mean, Malcolm X, Andre the Giant, Nicole Brown Simpson.
Mario Chalmers is not a great guy, Justin.
Oh, please. Yeah, lucky. He's just talking because he's talking about the Miami Heat. Oh, but speaking of NBA, let's make this very, very quick. Snowman also messaged me. I'm going to get them on that rant when he comes back.
Hey, speaking of which, where did he go?
Game two, the Golden State Warriors, they prevailed last night. Let's make this quick. 118-91. I got to ask you gentlemen this. Are the Warriors going to end this series in five games? I honestly think that you know what? I agree with Snowman. I say after the Warriors were fed up this one, they lost game one. They bounced back and destroyed the Thunder. I don't see any way, anyhow, that the Thunder will still make this a competitive series.
It's too predictable.
Hey, what's going on, Justin? How are you doing today? Justin and I promised to do a blab with him. I think we may do it tonight. I'm trying to get something set up here. Let me apologize to you gentlemen for being late. Was in a meeting. Oh, Sean, what the fuck?
What?
I need one of the
Hey, Sean, this is a salute to you. As much as we pick on you, this is a salute to you, my friend.
Thank you very much. And I got something. I got a little bone to pick with you, Snowman. We get there. All right.
Why do you have a bone to pick with me? What the fuck?
I'll get to that in just a sec. Game two, the Warriors, of course, congratulations, Snowman. The Warriors prevailed 118-91 last night.
Boring.
And tonight. Hey,
watch your mouth, Joshua.
I have to say this. The Warriors are going to win games three and four against the Thunder. Game one was a lucky win for the Thunder. And you knew the Warriors were desperate. You knew that this team was ready to fight back. Game two tonight of the Eastern Conference Finals, Toronto Raptors at the Miami Heat. The Cleveland Cavaliers.
You know something,
Sean? Fuck that game.
Watch SmackDown tonight.
I don't care what Justin says. I don't care what anybody says about the Cleveland Cavaliers. Number one, they're going down tonight. Number two, this Eastern Conference Final is going to be even more boring than last year. All right.
I want to find the ratings for the NBA playoffs and see how much of the American public is really.
Nobody cares about ratings anymore.
I know the ratings.
This is true.
Hey, okay. Snowman, I need one of those jackets, man. That looks awesome.
Oh,
see that, guys? The ASN jackets.
Hey, we're gonna get a few of these, okay? I got to get one to Sean so we can cover up that god awful shirt that he's wearing.
Yes. Yeah, look at that t-shirt. Yeah. Okay, now the bone to pick with Snowman that I had for the intro and opening rant that was in fun though, as I was kidding as I was saying this. A few days ago, I got a message from Snowman about college football and this top 25 stuff. What in the hell do I need to focus on that? We're in the month of May, for Christ's sake. I'm not ready for football season. Give me a break.
Okay. Sean, I'll respond in kind. Number one, you know you're ready for football because you're wearing that god-awful shirt. Number two, you're a closet college football fan. And number three, take this. Bitch!
Hey, it's the money. All right. For Christ's sake, we're not.
All right, Sean.
Oh man.
Hey, Mr. Mr. Free Willy. I need to address Free Willy's attorney, otherwise known as Pablo Sandoval. Hey, Sean, please hit the Skippy Bash song, please.
All right, hold on.
I got it.
Ladies and gentlemen. Boys and girls, the man with the shocks is here, and Frank Sprinkle, the man who's got his items up for bid, is here, and he has to hear his ridiculous crap, and same with me, and so does Justin and Browning and everybody here. And we got a man that is so tired day after day and night after night having to type down these Skippy quotes. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this is what we love to do. It's our comedy hour. It's the Skippy Bayless Bash Hour.
Oh, no. Play it, Sean. Play it. It's not wired through here. Play it.
Mine is up ready, and just in case, even though it's. Hold on. Wait for it to
pop open here. Here we go.
Dun, 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 dun. That's appropriate.
Take your headphones off.
Oh,
take your headphones off.
My headphones. Sean, take it.
Hold on. We want to hear this song. You got your headphones on.
You mean I have to take the headphones off?
Yes. Yes.
That would help.
I got it. I got it.
All day long, and now it is our turn. We all there know he's a moron, but now the real stars fight back.
One more time, damn it.
For good luck.
Yes. Yeehaw.
Are you a cowboy?
Now it is our turn. We all know, baby.
No cornbread, man.
But now,
what kind of profile picture are you changing, Browning? I don't want to see.
All right. The Skippy Bayless Bash Hour, as well as all of our programming and content on Arena Sportsnet, is brought to you in part by Cleaver Supplements, pure supplements for when genetics are just not enough. Today's show is brought to you by Wiltfang Builders, the sponsor of the fourth inning of our baseball coverage. Wiltfang Builders, give them a call at 219-996-7131. And also brought to you by Susie's Diner of Hebron, Indiana. Susie's Diner, home to the great biscuits and gravy and home to the original breakfast. They're at 407 South Main Street in Hebron, Indiana. Let's go, John. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Signature question. How many minds do we have today?
Yeah, how many?
Sean, I apologize in advance for the quotes that's going to piss you off today. I took a look at them last night, and if you thought Sean snapped yesterday, this way would see today, other day. I apologize, Frank. We have 34 mice.
What? Oh, my gosh. Wow.
You know what? I am
34 mice. Wow.
Josh, what is this? Walter Payton. What is this, an honor of Walter Payton or something? What the hell? 34?
Dude, let me ask you.
I think this is the most we've had in a while.
Quotes. That's why.
Anytime I go over 30, Skip Bayless usually goes like a full prediction of mice.
Oh, gosh, here we go. Let's go. Let's get it on.
Yeah, let's.
Hey, let's get Snowman rebooted here because his screen froze.
Yeah, it's a David Ortiz number. He wears number 34.
He went full Han Solo mode on this.
Gosh, I know everybody. You know what? Dictionaries. Just anytime you sell a dictionary, just draw a picture of Skip Bayless on the mind, and then we'll know what the meaning of that is. Look at Justin Han Solo mode. Ha ha.
All right, come. I think Snowman needs to log into his ASN account.
Yeah, log into the ASN there, bud. 34 mice. Good grief. I cannot believe this.
Yeah, I need Snowman's reaction for this quote in order to get the full laughter going, okay?
What profile picture did you just put up there, Browning? It better not be directed toward me. I'm upset with Skip Bayless.
Here's about profile picture, Sean.
Justin, I prefer Google Hangouts because you have a guarantee that the show will be recorded and there's no shenanigans.
All right, let's get the mics. Let's get these over with. Yeah, I want to live.
Ah, come on, Snowman. I was about to see it.
Come on, Snowman.
What's he doing? What's going on?
I got my phone ready if he wants to call in if he's having difficulty.
Hey, text him and tell him to log into his ASN account. Uh-huh. I don't know why he's going off Twitter.
Yep.
Snowman, use your ASN account. That'll probably help you out better.
Let me in here. Confusing. Okay.
You got it fixed?
We're ready?
I think what happened, I called my provider for an upgrade in speed, and I think that's what just happened. I think that's what just took place. So I'm good now. Let's go.
All right, let's go. Here we go.
me.
That's just warming up. Uh-oh.
Skippy Bayless said that John Farrell is the George Bush of managing.
It's one. There were two of them. Hey, we get to see your hair.
Jeez, even the glasses. Yeah. Even the glasses.
Oh, it's a contract extension.
It's an extension. And they are 25 and 60. Shut up about the Walmart haircut, Justin. We're talking about Skip Bayless here. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, look at that. What the hell is that on your head?
I'm surprised.
It's my candy.
Yeah, I'm surprised. I'm surprised Gluey Humpty, you didn't stir up a mic quote.
Well, hey, pick your poison, because here comes the mic quote.
Oh, dear Lord.
He's got an extension, you stupid idiot.
Hey, shut up. Mic quote.
He's still going to get fired.
Max!
Skippy Bale said that my...
Here we go.
New York Knicks made a great decision signing Jeff Hornacek as their new head coach.
That's bullshit. That's some grade-A homogenized Holstein Camping World Stadium Madison Square Garden presented by Chase bullshit.
Hey, do you know who has a better head coach than the New York Knicks? The Minnesota Timberwolves.
With Tom Thibodeau.
Yeah, Tom Thibodeau. If you're the New York Knicks, how do you let Tom Thibodeau get away?
Because maybe they would have been so stupid.
Because Tom Thibodeau wanted to be the coach and the GM. That's why. No.
Maybe George Karl could have been a better fit as Knicks head coach than Jeff Hornacek.
No. Please. That guy's done. He should call it quits when he has the chance.
No, that's...
All right, Sean, I apologize for this next one.
Oh, no.
The look on Sean's face should tell y'all everything.
Will Sean need a straight jacket after this?
Yes. Yeah, like the one Dean Ambrose was put on this past Thursday on SmackDown? Yes.
I'm sure there's a my here.
Okay, a straight jacket is required. This frightens me.
Okay, here we go. Skippy Bayless said Aaron Boone's home run against the Yankees in 2003 was the best home run in playoff history.
What about Joe Carter? Joe Carter's won a World Series. What about Bill Mazeroski? That won a World Series.
How about Paul
Aaron Freaky Boone?
Scott Pitsunik? How about Scott Pitsunik? That won a World Series game.
Okay. Y'all want to see Sean go from 0 to 200 pissed off in 2 seconds?
No, I love Sean.
In the immortal word, Justin says yes. In the immortal words of one Dennis, I know this is going to require a boot, but I hate to do it, and I have to. In the immortal words of one Dennis Leary, Bucky fucking Dent.
You know what? Aaron Boone didn't do jack crap the entire goddamn 2003 ALCS.
He sent Pedro home. What do you mean he didn't do anything?
He only hit. He didn't hit like 165, 167 in the ALCS. Bucky Dent barely hit
175, and he hit the home run that knocked out the Boston Red Sox.
Skip Bayless? Shut up, you Nimrod. I can tell you one thing. How did 2004 feel when the Skankies made the biggest collapse in the history of the rivalry? Red Sox were down 3 games to none, and then they won 4 in a row.
Hey,
God, we have 31 other quotes to get to. We have no time for a history lesson.
Yeah, we don't need to. Yeah.
Well, somebody's got to teach him a history lesson.
No, Sean, shut up. We got to get to other quotes here. We don't have time for history.
All right, you want a divisional quote? This one should be.
Oh, God, I'm going to die.
Here we go, Frank. Scooby Bell said to mine. My Baltimore Orioles will win the AL East over my New York Yankees, my Boston Red Sox, my Tampa Bay Rays, my Toronto Blue Jays.
That is the biggest bunch of bull crap I've ever heard in my life. Oh, the Orioles? Okay, they're playing good ball. I get that. Skippy. But the point is, Skippy, that the Red Sox are right on
best
their tail.
Best reaction ever. Best reaction ever.
Yeah.
You know what, Skippy? The Orioles haven't won a World Series, Skippy, since 1983, Skippy!
Hey. Skippy!
I think we have something we can all use now. Thank you, Sean. Thank you very much.
Yeah, can we record that?
I think yes. we have something we can all use now. And
let's go to the next one.
I have something I know I can use.
Nice! Yes! I love that button. All right, this one's for Snowman.
Oh,
here we go.
For everybody.
Skippy Bayless said that Josh Gordon's a better receiver than Jerry Rice.
Hopefully. I'd be doing that now.
Okay, Josh Gordon is high and full of shit. Skippy Bayless is higher and full of shit. Okay, if Josh Gordon ever learned how to catch a ball, then maybe, just maybe, he'll be somewhat a little bit on the caliber of the great Jerry Rice. But Josh Gordon, a better receiver than Jerry Rice? Skip Bayless, you said that once about Dez Bryant. You said that once about Miles Austin. You said that once about anybody that is not – yeah, I went there, Josh. And you said that about anybody that is not named Jerry Rice. I hate to inform you of this, Skip Bayless, but the greatest receiver of all time wore 80. Last name, Rice. Jerry Rice, that is. And I'm done.
Skippy Bayless said that Ernie Banks is the most overrated Chicago sports player of all time.
Oh, that's bullshit.
That's bullshit. Hey, you know what? There's other great athletes that came out of Chicago. Let's see. Bobby Hall played in Chicago. Wait, but what about Michael Jordan and Walter Payton? I forgot about those two. Are they overrated as well?
How about Scottie Pippen? Add him.
Yeah, how about Scottie Pippen?
Don't bring up Scottie Pippen because Skippy Bayless says Scottie Pippen is not even a top 50 player.
I'll even mention Paul Konerko, another number four.
Look at some man's face.
I have to say this too. This is exactly the way Skippy would be, everybody, dissing Chicago and saying it's a crappy place and they got overrated.
Hey, the only bad thing that ever came out of Chicago was Kanye West. That's it. Snowman, the floor is yours.
Wait, Bayless went for the Tribune. That's what all that was also bad.
Turn your mic on.
Turn your mic on, bud.
Maybe he doesn't want to turn it on after that quote.
Nothing. Can't hear diddly squat.
Snowman, I can't hear you, bud.
I don't think he wants to say anything after that one.
Calling Ernie Banks overrated. I said that's addressed to Frank since he's the Cubs fan.
Hey, Sean, this quote's for you, buddy.
Oh, you ready? God. I don't know if I'll be ready. Go ahead.
Skippy Bell said to my my Boston Bruins should sign Todd Bertuzzi.
Ooh, how about that, Sean?
The guy's like almost 50 years old. What the hell is he going to do with the Bruins? Sit on the bench like Pablo Sandoval?
Yeah, but at least he's in shape.
He's
good boy.
He's 50 years old. What, Skip Bayless? You don't know anything about the Boston Bruins. Leave him alone. Why don't you go focus on another hockey team?
Okay,
that is if you know what hockey is.
Do y'all have me now?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
And the floor is yours about Chicago sports, there, Snowman,
or whatever you want to talk about involving Skip Bayless.
Skip Bayless. You don't think Scottie Pippen is a top 50 player? You're not even a top 500 analyst, okay? The fact that Scottie Pippen came in with the natural tools that he had, he was supposed to be with Seattle, but Seattle was stupid and gave him up.
Olin Polonese.
Yep, for Olin Polonese, and Scottie Pippen became one of the 50 greatest players in history. And the reason that Scottie Pippen is one of the 50 greatest players in history, you won't say that about LeBron James. I'll never say that about LeBron James. But the reason that Scottie Pippen is one of the 50 greatest players in history is something that LeBron James does not have. How about a defensive presence? How about defensive capability? How about the fact that Scottie Pippen has been elected to the all-defensive first team 11 times? The 10 selections for LeBron James to the all-defensive first team are a farce. Why? Because the only thing that LeBron James has in his arsenal is a chase down block. And sometimes he gets beaten on the chase down block, like, oh, Stephen Curry, like, oh, Derrick Rose, like, oh, Jimmy Butler. Okay.
Nate Robinson.
Oh, Kawhi Leonard. Oh, Russell Westbrook. Oh, let's see. James Harden. Okay.
Tony Parker.
He gets beaten on the chase. And I hate to be as vulgar as I'm going to be, but A, Skip Bayless is involved. B, Scottie Pippen is involved. And C, the concept of defense is involved, which is something that is not played that much in the NBA anymore. So no, I'm going to I am going to absolutely go there. I hate to inform you of this, Skip, but LeBron James is about as soft defensively as a woman's stomach when pregnancy begins, okay? LeBron James is about as soft as my daughter's pillow, okay? And my daughter's pillow, the night she came home, was pretty doggone soft, okay? That's how LeBron James's game has been for the 12 years that he's been in the NBA. You know what I say else? You know what else I say? Scottie Pippen has hit more clutch shots in one season than LeBron James has hit in 12 seasons. The only clutch shot that I give LeBron James credit for that actually sealed up a game or a championship is 13 in game number 7 when he actually had the ball is in his hands. LeBron is softer than Alshon Jeffrey, all right? Let's just go there, okay? Now, Pippen is top 50 because of his defense, because of his scoring prowess, and the way he penetrates. In fact, he redesigned the position of point forward. Magic Johnson was a 6'9" point guard. Scottie Pippen was the point forward. He will be the quintessential point forward. And unlike what you think, Skip Bayless, Scottie Pippen is top 50, period.
Period.
Nice.
I have to say this, too. Without Michael Jordan always knew that he needed some help, and yes, Scottie Pippen was always there for him all the time, and he was always
Luke Longley is a better defender than LeBron James.
Well, yeah, the Bulls, look at that. Luke Longley,
Ron
Tony
Harper is a better defender than LeBron James.
Ron Harper, Steve Kerr.
Stacey King is a better defender than LeBron James.
Hey, Josh, I'll do you one better. Rodney McRae is a better defender than LeBron James.
Elton Brand, when he was with the Bulls, was a better defender than LeBron.
Tyson Jones,
better defender. I got. My ears are bleeding. Shut up, Justin. I got one for Sean. Danny Ainge was a better defender than LeBron James. Okay.
Ooh. Oh hell Ronnie, yeah,
Ronnie. You want to know if there's any for you? Come on, I'll let you know right now. I have two for you, you rat bastard.
He always wants something.
Hey, let's get to more of these my quotes. I want to.
Yes. Well, if there's two for Browning, one of us should leave. I can just leave because I want to see his reaction. Right, yeah, I'll boot myself out. Here we go. Let's Browning, come on in.
Mr. Clean.
Why do I get the feeling this is going to be enjoyable?
Because the land. Look at that red.
Oh, wow. I love that logo.
What's going on, Browning? I love that logo, my friend. I love it. By the way, to you folks, that watch the show every day, the Twitter handle that you see for me is my personal Twitter handle. All right. Y'all usually see me sign in with the business handle Arena Sportsnet, but today I'm using the personal one. All right. What do we got? What do we got from Brian?
Yeah, I want to hear this.
Ready for the Shacklemeter 5,000, bud?
Or 3,000. Yeah. And Frank, I got your back.
All right. Please. Here we go. Skippy Bale said to my. My Philadelphia Eagles should bring in Caleb Haney as a backup quarterback.
Hey, there you go.
Dear Lord.
Yeah, Caleb Haney. He played in an NFC championship game. Come on, Browning. What did Sam Bradford do?
Sam Bradford did crap.
By the way, can I respond in Browning's presence with this?
Everybody get time for me.
There you go.
This one will definitely get Brownie going.
Oh no!
me.
It is warming up.
Skippy Bayless said that the Eagles should cut Sam Bradford and bring in Johnny Manziel when they have the chance.
Oh, that's a good one. That's a good one.
Ah, there he goes. Look at there he goes.
He's gone. To come back now. Hey, Brownie, that's on you. You're out.
And Browning, screw you and your lousy, stupid profile picture. I saw that, you bastard.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah, hey, Browning, you can have this.
We got to have one quote that gets Sean in an absolute cuss fit. We haven't had one of those yet. Y'all heard me go off. You've heard Josh go off. Frank is going off. We got to have one that gets Sean in an absolute George Carlin, Richard Pryor. Let me think. Here's a trio for you. We got to have one that gets Sean in an absolute George Carlin, Richard Pryor, Red Fox, Lewis Black cuss fit.
Cuss fit?
Okay. Give me one second, please.
Oh, no.
Oh, my Lord.
I got to make sure I got this right.
All right.
Okay. Skippy Bayless said that Carl Crawford is a better left fielder than Ted Williams.
Really? Here it is.
That's my biggest bunch of BS I've ever heard of in my life.
Dude, somebody get him. Somebody call 911.
You stupid idiot! How could you say something like that? Ted Williams is the greatest pitter who ever lived. You stupid, god dang, lousy bitch! You freaking idiot! Oh my goodness!
Oh no! Oh no!
Oh Frank, shush and get out! I don't need to hear it. And I have
thank you, Josh. Thank you, Josh Lopez.
Dude, somebody call 911.
Thank you, Josh Lopez.
Thanks, buddy. I appreciate it. Man, look at Justice has the hashtag. Thank you.
Thank you, Josh Lopez.
Actually, should it be hashtag thank you, Glowy Hump?
Correct.
You know what, Skip Bayless? Why do you think the Red Sox booted Carl Crawford and traded him? Because he was a distraction. He only hit 214 in the 2011 season. Ted Williams could hit more than Carl Crawford.
Well, come on, it's Bobby Valentine's fault, right?
Oh, that guy was a clown.
Really?
Clown!
It was Bozo. It was Krusty. He's a clown.
Oh, by the way, you're going to love this.
Oh, I will.
Y'all look in the chat room and see what Browning just wrote.
What did he write? Oh, yeah, the Red Sox.
That's the panda you're talking about. What are
oh,
you
I got a panda quote.
About?
I got a panda quote.
There you go. Oh, no. Here's, okay, let's play
it. I'm going to go hide now.
Skippy said it was great to see Panda in the new Jungle Book movie.
Well, let me ask you, he ain't gonna win an Academy Award, will he?
No, live action Jungle Book movie, by the way, I'm talking
well,
about.
Well, why not? I mean, to have something named after the panda, I mean, come on, the Jungle Book's a popular movie right now.
Hey, let Free Willy sail out here, please. Oh, man. All right. Who's ready for the next one?
I am, dude. I am. Ready. I'm ready.
Okay. This one's for Frank. Okay.
Oh,
okay.
Oh no.
Hey, I'm not going to go up like Sean, though.
Yeah. Skippy Bell said that the Chicago Bears should bring Mark Trestman back as the offensive coordinator.
Boy, let me ask you, is Skip tripping on some serious acid here?
I mean, really,
hey, Skippy Bayless, your mother would be a better offensive coordinator than Mark Trestman. Shut up!
You know what? I would be a better offensive coordinator than Mark Trestman. We'd pass the ball more.
Hey, folks, here's one.
That's terrible.
Here's two.
Down.
Here's three.
That's what I was waiting for.
And Josh, this is for you.
Hey, what about stay off the weed? That should be in there as well.
I'll save that.
I get it that Soldier Field's a freaking dump in a planet ship, but come on, we need Mark Trestman to grace us with his presence again. Come on, man.
We tried that. It didn't work. Wait, the Bears tried that. It didn't work.
What's next? Is Skip Bayless going to come out and say, I should be offensive coordinator for the Chicago Bears?
No. He said this, though. Skip Bayless said he wants to be the owner of my New England Patriots.
Well, that's already taken. Sorry.
He's about to die in 50 years. So don't.
What? No way. I would not want him as owner of the Patriots. That'd make me sick.
All right. And quite frankly, I disagree with you. I think Skip Bayless has the perfect qualifications to be a great owner.
Yeah, that's according to you, not Stephen A. Smith. The guy mentions my all the time.
Relax, relax, Sean. He's not going to be the owner of the Patriots or any NFL team.
How about he could be owner of the Cubs, Frank?
Sean. Yeah, whatever.
Sean. I got one for you. Everybody knows Sean was a fan of the Jets, and he claims to be a fan of the Patriots, but I did some research, and I know Sean's real football team.
It is.
Oh, Vikings, let's win this game.
Oh, God. This is the worst song ever.
Damn.
The White Sox song is better
you know
than
what?
I know that.
That should add to another opening rant. Last night, Snowman, I'm watching the Red Sox Royals game. You messaged me on my messenger, and I asked, why do you send me a song of that cursed loser organization called the Vikings?
Because that's your team.
That's my family's team. I don't go for the Vikings. They're cursed. They were cursed when they lost four Super Bowls.
Admit it, Sean. You're a Teddy Bridgewater mark. Come on. Admit it.
Oh, yeah, let's just spy in Sean's closet and see if he's got a Teddy Bridgewater jersey.
Okay. In Sean's closet, you'll find a jersey of Bridgewater, a jersey of Curtis, my favorite, Martin. You'll find a jersey of Adrian Peterson. God, don't know. I don't know why.
There's a Keyshawn Johnson jersey in there.
Yeah, I'm sure there is.
There's a
Smith.
No. I've got Patriots.
You got a Rex Ryan hoodie.
Oh, timeout. Let's show. Yeah, hold on. I got here.
Oh, dear Lord. What have you guys done?
What did you do? Josh, why did you say that?
I'll tell you what, since we don't want to see it, I'm going to have to do this for the sake of all of us.
Oh, no. He's going to be pissed when he gets back.
I don't give a beavers you know what.
Thank you. Someone got bumped. Yes, indeed.
In the meantime, another Skippy quote. Here we go.
Let's do it. Hurry up.
Good. Hurry.
Skippy Bell said that my...
I got it, Frank.
No, we don't have time for that. We got to go on.
Go.
My Philadelphia 76ers will win the NBA championship next year.
That's some great A. homogenized Holstein Wells Fargo Center bullshit.
Well, come on. Ben Simmons is the greatest player of all time. Yeah.
No, that would be Michael Jordan. That would be Magic Johnson. That would be Larry Bird. That would be anybody. But thank you, Bronny Master.
Nice. All right. All right, Walmart boy, come back in.
Here he comes.
Oh, no. Yeah, right there. There you go. Yeah.
Hey, it's the Bill Belichick special on sale.
Are y'all loving this as much as I am?
Yeah, I am. I am.
This is the best segment in all sports. Hey, Sean, cool, I apologize for this next quote.
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
Why are you apologizing? There's no reason to apologize.
I like to be courteous to my friends here so they don't act like I'm Skip Bayless.
Just go.
You're not Skip Bayless. You're a lot Frank, better.
Just go. Let's get this out of the way.
But Frank, hold on, let's get the call. That's the counts.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, Snowman, I agree with you, buddy. I appreciate it.
Not a problem.
All right. This is a panda quote. So,
another one on the panda. Here we go.
That is. Shut up.
Skippy Bayless said that Pablo Sandoval has a humpback like the humpback for Notre Dame.
Talk about an insult. There you go.
Three championships.
Hunchback of Notre Dame.
Wow.
He's got three championships. He's an MVP. 2012 MVP one with more the Giants. Time.
Tell Free Willy to go work out for once, please.
Why bring Free Willy into this? Those were movies. Because
he's a fat whale. That's what he is.
Tell him to be like me. I'm gonna exercise later. Tell him to be like me.
Browning, you are asking for trouble and cruising for a bruising with your profile, and now that coming
for a bruising.
Yeah.
Oh, God. I guess that's the saying. You're bumblefuck USC.
I believe I better press this button.
All right, here we go. That. Skippy Bayless said that Clay Buchholz is wasting his time being a Red Sox.
Damn.
You know what? You know what, Skip Bayless? You are wasting your time being an analyst. Why don't you go find another profession, you dumb idiot?
I like that one.
I just got a quote here.
Can I read it, Frank? Yes.
Okay. Skip Bayless says that Fenway Park is a monkey turd infested sinkhole.
Johnny can't boo people. I see you.
What do you mean?
You're not fooling me, boy. I see you go for that mouse.
Hold it. Frank booted me out.
And I booted him out after that.
Yeah, okay, good. All right. You know what, Frank?
You're not fooling me, Walmart boy.
Hey, Skip Bayless, Fenway Park is better than you because it's got class, and that's the cathedral. Watch your mouth, you dork. Oh,
the cathedral. Give me a break, man. Nobody wants to go to church in that dump.
Sure. How come it's ranked number one out of the top 10 ballparks or the top 20? Because it's got the smelliest
parks. The number one smelliest park.
And what does that make U.S. Cellular Field? Another shitty dump place because it has nothing at all.
Hey, it's clean. It's got new video boards.
It's 10 times better looking than Fenway.
It's easy to get to by a CTA.
Hey,
hi, Gio.
Browning.
Hey, we got some
Browning.
Thank you, Browning.
Hey, Frank, and Wrigley Field is a shaggy old field that deserves to be booted and torn down, and the Cubs need a new ballpark.
All right. Well, this next one's for Justin.
Let's go on.
Justin want to come in or no?
I can get out.
Bring Justin in. I want to hear this.
All right, Frank.
I like
all right, Justin, it's your turn, buddy.
This Patriots thing is comfortable that I'm wearing. Nice and warm. Yeah.
I'm surprised it is comfortable on you, considering it's a Patriots shirt.
Patriots rock and rule.
Patriots suck.
Oh, your camera's not working, Justin? What the heck?
Well, I'll say this to you in advance. Skippy Bayless said that my...
Oh, boy.
I got it. My Miami Heat should fire Eric Spoelstra right now.
Oh, Justin, that's addressed to you.
Won't happen.
No.
Damn.
Well, I have to say,
do it, Justin, right, Frank.
Damn.
Hey, by the way, can we blast some Todd Rundgren in this bitch, please?
Sure, why don't we?
Well, I hate to say this, but
I don't
have it.
Oh, well, that's a great A homogenized whole barbecues bullshit. I know you got this song in there. Come on.
Shush for a moment. Save it for tomorrow. It's Friday. It's Podluck Friday tomorrow. Save it for then.
There you go.
I'm blasting it now.
Wake up, Josh. As in, I heard something.
I did that yesterday for you, Josh.
I saw that. It was great.
I did that for you, my friend.
Oh, man. By the way, we'll try to mix this in trivia tomorrow for Potluck Friday, all right?
Oh, yeah, I can't wait for that. Potluck Friday, anything goes.
You know what, Browning? Shut up about your profile picture already. Let's just focus
on I would love to see Sean and Browning in an asylum match. Really? How about that?
Yeah, I'll win, just like he loses in bowling.
I want to see Sean and Browning in a Punjabi prison match.
Oh, no. Please, I've seen that match in person. That's brutal.
How many does did we have? We only had like two of those, didn't we?
Dude, the worst wrestling match I've seen in person is Batista versus Great Khali in a Punjabi prison match.
I saw that. That was a
picture.
Okay, wait
what's
a minute.
What's the next Skippy quote?
Yeah, what's the next one?
All
right. No, Bronny, you're in the match. You would be in the asylum. Me, Snowman, and Frank would have the front row seats.
Oh, that'd be sweet. Yes, I would love that.
Oh, Bronny said he would win.
Hey, Browning, zip your lips. Let's go. Next one.
All right, here we go. Next one. This one's for Sean. Here we go. Skippy Bale said to Maya. My boss is salty. Should get rid of Danny Age. Out of management.
Wait, we really are pushing Sean's buttons today, or at least Skip Bayless's, or maybe.
Bayless, you push my buttons all the time when you talk about that. Danny Age is turning the team around.
I have something to add to that.
Go ahead.
Would you repeat that? Would you repeat that quote, please?
Skip Bayless said to mine. Boston Celtics should get rid of Danny Age out of management.
Yeah. I really think okay, Sean's going to kill me for this. A, I'm inclined to agree. And B, they should clean house.
No, Sean. No.
This is not fair.
That's right, Bartman. I think fair.
Nope.
I'm kidding, Sean. Jesus.
I know, Snowman, but I have to say the Skip Bayless. Danny Ainge actually came in May of 2003, knew it was going to take work to change the Celtics around. Didn't he win a championship when he was with the Celtics?
That's when he was a player. Look at Michael Jordan. He hasn't won shit with the Bobcats.
Not as a player, Josh, as a part of the owners. He was director of basketball operations. We all remember what happened in 2008 when the Boston Celtics won Banner 17. I saw the whole thing, and I loved it.
Wow. Yo, Browning. Love that new cover photo, my friend.
What the heck? What is it?
I love that. Yes.
Did you see it, Josh?
Yes.
Did you see it, Josh?
That's logo in sports.
That is a cool logo.
Is that a White Sox logo that he put up there?
Yeah, do you have a problem with
it? Yes.
Or should I say Chicago Shit Sox?
Thank you. I was about to do that.
Boot.
All right, let's snowman route. I haven't had a quote for him for a while.
Player with the bumpers, it didn't come out right.
What the fuck? What now?
Skippy Bayless said to my.
Oh boy.
My Golden State Warriors have nothing on the Miami Heat from the 2013-2014 season.
Oh, yeah, well, you know what? You're right, Skip Bayless. They don't have anything on the Miami Heat of 2013.
Here we go. I know you can sing.
Because the Golden State Warriors are 50 times better than that 2013 championship Miami team. And Justin, you're going to hate my conspiracy theory, but I still believe that 2013 championship was handed to them.
Okay. I found an ironic that he used that team.
Wait a minute.
He actually look lost his first reaction. That year.
Look at Justin's reaction.
hey, Skip, do your research. The Heat lost that year to the Spurs in 5 games, you dumbass.
2014.
And you know what? I reply to this, Justin.
I need to correct something. And this time, Josh, allow Sean to boot me for this correction.
Okay.
But after looking at that shot 100 times, that was a three. He was a foot behind the line in the corner. I looked at that shot. Listen. I'm being fair to Ray Allen and nobody else on that team, okay? I'm being fair to Ray Allen only. When you look at the main shot on, forgive me, ABC that televised the finals, it looked like he was not behind the line. I have the shot where they had zoomed on him in the corner. That was a tray. That was a home run. And I looked at it. Trust me, guys. Y'all know how much of a madman I am when it comes to research, unlike Skip Bayless, unlike Stephen A. Smith, unlike anybody else at ESPN, save Chris Berman. Okay? Y'all know what a madman I am when it comes to research, And Josh, you should know this because you and I went head to head a couple times and we did our research before we did go head to head and wound up laughing at the end of the hour we did go head to head. That was a three. And that's just for Ray Allen only. That's the only person I'm giving credit to. And LeBron, were it not for Ray Allen, LeBron would not be celebrating. That was, I hate saying this, but I've got to give credit where credit is due, and I've got to say it. That indeed was, from the looks of it, it was a two, okay? But looking at Ray Allen's motion, the way he leapt in the air to take that shot, both feet were indeed, both feet were indeed behind the line. We're talking about the 2013 Finals, Game 6. That was a three.
Ah! I hate to say it, too. LeBron James, you're lucky you actually have won championships because you should not have won in 2012. You were lucky that you won that. If the Celtics would have been prepared for Game 6 in the 2012 Eastern Conference Finals, they would have booted that stupid Heat team. Right. LeBron James got freaking lucky. 2013, luck again. The only reason why is because San Antonio also didn't make their goddamn free throws.
Okay, Josh, how many do we have?
Four.
What do we have?
Kind of like Rick Anderson in 1995. While Josh gets the last quote, Whitey, I got to go take out my lunch. I'll be right back.
All right, let's get to that quote.
All right. Skippy Bayless said that Mo Vaughn was a better defender than Pablo Sandoval.
Mo Vaughn played for the Red Sox. You can't argue with that.
I grew up with Mo Vaughn in the 90s. I grew up watching him in the 90s for the Red Sox.
On that note, that's the end of the Scooby Bayless Bash Hour. I have some more quotes for you tomorrow. Good, Sean, react.
I grew up watching Mo Vaughn. I mean, Mo Vaughn had power. I mean, he could hit. He could torch anybody. I mean, he was a Yankee killer. I mean, Mo Vaughn was great.
He was great.
Sean. What? I'm going to piss off Sean, and I'm going to make Josh smile at the same time. I'm going to make Justin laugh. I'm going to make Browning Master laugh, and I'm going to piss off Sean to the nth degree all at the same time.
And you'll make the big win laugh, too.
I'll make the big win laugh with this statement when I say this. Jim Tomey blindfolded was better than Mo Vaughn.
Ooh.
What was that?
That's the body language of a spoiled little brat.
Hey, you know
Albert
what?
Albert Bell is better player than Pablo Sandoval.
I can't believe it.
Since we're talking about left-handed hitters, hey, Josh, you want a bigger smile?
Yes.
I know somebody that was left-handed or is left-handed that can swing a better bat than Mo Vaughn. And you know who that player is?
Who?
Considering the ties, I know I'm going to get a reaction from Sean when I say A.J. Pierzynski.
Yes.
Do we have to bring up 05? You just give me those nightmares every goddamn time. Hey, I'll never forget.
What was his last name? Frank, do you remember the third baseman from the Yankees from the championship years?
Oh, wait, you're talking about the late 90s.
Yes.
Charlie Hayes,
yes.
That's not Charlie Hayes. Scott something.
Scott Brocious.
Scott Brocious was the word better than Pablo Sandoval.
Or in the words of Chris Berman, Sean, Scott supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Yeah, okay. I got to hear about all this past about how great the Yankees are. They suck.
Sean, since we're talking about left hand, and I know we got to go to fact or fiction.
Yeah, let's get that underway.
I know a left-handed batter that did more in the playoffs than Mo Vaughn ever did.
And who was that?
Scott Podsednik.
Who the heck is Scott Podsednik?
The guy who had a walk-off run off of Boston pitching in the 2005 playoffs, you bastard.
You know what? What have they done in the last 11 years? I think they're beginning to slip.
The only guy – what the fuck? Thank you. Oh, and by the way,
we gotta move on.
by the way, Sean, I leave you with this. Scott Pitsetnik did something that David Ortiz has not done.
What is that exactly?
A walk-off World Series home run.
Ortiz had a walk-off home run in Game 4 of the ALCS in 04.
He said World Series, not AL Championship Series.
You didn't hear what I said. And Sean's laughing because he knows it's true. And Sean's trying to be mad, and he knows it's true.
You know what, right, Justin? I like Johnny Damon as a Red Sox, but don't
I'm
get
sure
mad.
You did, Sean. Fact or fiction? Maybe we could piss off Sean more on fact or fiction.
Yes.
Let's go to
fact or fiction. And here's how I'm going to signal my answers. I'm going to signal fiction with. Oh, wait. Not loud enough. Buzzer. I'm going to signal fiction with. And I'm going to signal fact with. All right.
Yep. All right. Skippy Bailey. Ah!
Damn it. It's your fault, dude. Skippy Bailey's fault. That's a big fault. That's a personal foul. Personal foul, dude.
Oh, shut up, Frank. Let's get on to this.
Josh, look at the screen. Josh, I have to do this. if I may, kind sir. Penalty flag on the field. False start offense.
All right, here we go. Let's try it again. All right,
here we go. Let's try this. Quick reset. You're watching the Sports Drive and listening to the Sports Drive with Josh Lopez, Frank Sprankle, Sean Mann, Justin Hill, the Browning Master, and yours truly, the Golden Voice. We are presented by Cleaver Supplements, pure supplements for when genetics are just not enough. We were about to do fact or fiction, and then Josh botched it for this first one.
And also brought to you by every Walmart in the country. Go to Walmart and get your hair cut.
Will you shut up? Wait. And you wonder why I'm – thank you, Frank. And you wonder why I'm bald. I'm not going to Walmart. Oops. It's a boot vest. All right, here we go. Fact or fiction.
All right, here we go. First one. Fact or fiction. Pablo Sandoval will be on a new team next year.
Fact.
I have to vote, and I have to say that it's very likely it's going to be fact. And I have a feeling that even it may not be next year, he could be get traded for Chris Sale.
Yeah.
Kiss Frank, off. Come back in. Please come back in, Frank. All right. Oh, here he comes.
Here we go.
Fact or fiction.
Here we go.
Ouch!
LeBron James will sweep the Toronto Raptors.
Fiction.
Fiction. They'll get one in Toronto at least.
Justin's voting fact.
Yeah, Justin Hill says fact. I say fiction and back it up with Toronto winning in six games. Period.
Herod. Fact or fiction? Sean Mann will get a haircut at a different establishment in the coming year.
I'll say fact.
I'm going to say fiction on that because Walmart's the place to go where they wash my hair and take care of me.
You know what? I changed my mind.
I like it. All right. Next one. Fact or fiction? The Chicago Cubs will make it to the World Series this year.
I'm hoping
the way they're playing right now, I'll say fact.
I'll say fact too.
The way they're playing right now, of course, this is May and not September, and y'all know how I feel about that. But the way they're playing right now, if they solve their problems that they're going to have at the All-Star break, I will say fact.
I'll
say fact.
As a Red Sox fan, I'm going to vote and say fact on that because the Cubs have been unstoppable. And you know what? Before we go on, I got to make this quick. The Cubs are actually on a mission. They know very, very well they want to get it done and end 108 years of misery. They don't want this draft to go on.
Let's hear Josh's vote. I already know what it is. That's what I thought.
What's he gonna say, Josh? What are you gonna say there, bud?
Plus, nobody wants to see the Red Sox and Cubs against each other in the World Series.
Oh dear God!
Snooze. The Red Sox winning.
Snooze fest. Okay.
All right. Next one.
We'll see the White Sox and the Pirates. Period. All right.
Well, the White Sox are on a slump right now.
No, we get the point next one.
You have to rub that in. Hey, what was the last time there wasn't a gate that has to be involved with the Patriots Super Bowl championships? Spygate, Deflate Gate, Ref Gate.
Hey, come on, come on. Enough with the Boston. Let's move on.
I'm trying to move on, and you guys keep cutting me off.
Because you're mentioning too much Boston. Sorry. Let's get out with this.
I'm sorry, John.
There you go. Fact or fiction. The Golden State Warriors will win the NBA championship this year.
That is a big
fact. God damn it.
Who voted fiction? I said fact. Josh, did you say fiction?
Yes, I did.
Why? Why are you saying fiction? Look where they're at.
Because people assume this is the best team of all time in NBA history, and I think that's some grade A to homogenize whole buttercup bullshit.
I said this was the best team this year. I'm not saying – shut up, Justin.
I'm not saying you. I'm saying media members are saying it because they broke the Bulls record.
Okay. I said best team this year. Best of all time? There's a lot to be debated on that subject.
All right. Here we go.
And Justin, shut your trap. Although Justin, we both agree, and we talked about this, that the West Finals is the best playoff series, you know, this year. Mm-hmm. Even with I want to get a rise.
All right, next one.
Last one for today. Last one.
Fact or fiction? Pablo Sandoval will lose 100 pounds by the fall.
That is such a fact. He's going to be on a weight loss.
That you know what I got a fact. I got a fact for you. I'll lose 100 more pounds by Labor Day weekend. I'm gonna put myself out there because I need the support right now because I'm launching my personal blog on Monday. Fact or fiction? Yours truly will drop 100 pounds by Labor Day.
You will.
Fact.
Well, and I'm also saying it's hard to lose them a lot in the end though. So it'll take.
But also fact about the panda going on a weight loss program too, so he'll be back stronger than ever next year.
Yeah.
Pablo Sandoval looks like Tugboat.
Oh God!
You guys remember the wrestler Tugboat?
I remember Tugboat. Oh God!
Does he look like Dumbo?
I believe we have a spoken word to do. Do we not, yes, Josh? Yes.
Of course we do.
Yes, we do.
I'll put a little guitar behind it, and Josh, I want the gluey hump, the man in charge, the mayor gov, to kick off the spoken word before we get out of here.
Right to you,
my
Josh.
Spoken word today is be the authentic product that is yourself. I'm sorry I'm hacking Frank on this one, but
Hack alert.
You know, like I mentioned earlier, have the courage to form your own decisions for what's best for your future. Don't feel like you have to make decisions to impress your family members or your fake-ass friends. Just do what you have to do to make yourself happy. That's my spoken word.
Sean, to you.
You know what? Like I just said at the very beginning of the show, this is why with everything that's so sad around the world right now and our country, you know, it's why we like to have fun to get away from all the negativity and get away from everything because it is sad what we've seen. Again, my thoughts and prayers to the people who died in that plane crash going from Cairo, I believe it is, from Paris to Cairo. They were flying on a plane and then, of course, terrorism activity. It's really, really sad the way our world is right now. I mean, it's unfortunate. Our world's not safe. Our country's not safe. We're in a critical election year, and the important thing is that we do this show so we can bring a spark to the American public and for the whole world pretty much, just because it's really, really sad the way things are going. So be upbeat, be positive, and do the best you can. That's all you can do. That's all I do. That's all Frank does. That's all Josh does. And that is all that the snowman does too. I mean, it's just unfortunate the way the negativity and all the sad violence and hatred is these days, but that's why we try to make it positive by making the show fun and entertaining.
Okay.
Frank, to you.
Okay. 100% man. That's what I am. 100% me. That is what you see.
All right. I'll close out the spoken word by saying this, and to piggyback on what Sean said, there's too much negative bullshit going on in the world right now, and you need to navigate away from that because that steals your joy. And I had a young lady tell me this morning. Don't let anybody try to steal your joy, because that's all most people are trying to do, is to steal your joy and to steal the reason for your joy. Now, it was natural causes that took a part of my joy away from me in terms of my dad and in terms of my daughter. But I have their spirits within me. I have their smiles within me. And that pushes me to continue on and pushes me and continue to get better, to make this network better, and to do everything possible. The people that are trying to bring us down are not going to bring us down, because we're not going to let them. Period. Continue to push through your pain. Continue to push through your obstacles. And when there's a mountain in the way, don't try to climb it. Don't try to scale it. You know what to do? You move that sumbitch out of the way and chop it down to size. That's my spoken word.
Also, don't forget, have time to bust each other's chops and have some fun at the same time. Make sure to check out all the replays of the Sports Rev on my personal YouTube channel. Check out the brand new Josh Lopez Wrestling Podcast. We've got episode 4 up on iTunes now if you want to check it out.
That is a great podcast.
Thanks, buddy. I appreciate it. The support and downloading and spreading the word about the show will help the most. If you guys could leave like a review, comment, or something, it helps us with the charts. It's something small. You can even say like one sentence. You don't have to do a full review or whatever, but it's iTunes, Josh Lopez Wrestling Podcast, if you want to get my thoughts in the world of wrestling. Check out the Sports Drive every Mondays, Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays here on Blab, and most importantly, the Arena Sports Network. Also, don't forget, we got the Snowman in the Morning as well. That's also on the Arena Sports Network. Thank you to all our great sponsors, Kleepler Supplements, Dickie's Barbecue,
Twisted K Brewing, Crass Construction, Wilfang Builder, yeah. Susie's Diner, and many more.
Yeah, we're on Twitter at @DSports_Drive for Snowman, for the Walmart Boy, for Brownie Master with his great profile pictures here on Blab, for Justin. I am Gluey Hump, Josh Lopez. Thank you guys for checking out the Sports Drive. We hope you enjoyed the show as much as we had doing the show for you today. We are out.
Peace. See you tomorrow for Potluck Friday. Have a good one, everybody.
Yes.
Wow, Friday.